be that led or fleshly dead, living fully or resting in your coffin bed. Sound logic or idiotic practice, strengthen your heart or blow up your other muscles. Steal, kill and destroy or silence the spoiled boy within you. And finally become a proper man. Use your tool that was created for springing forth life to cause death for you and the next. Because the vet told you that your unshackled dog is sick. We call them fleas, you call them a one-night disease. Put both meanings together and you get suicide keys. Wrong is not wrong until caught. You try to hide from the master who created darkness. You rather lock yourself in the same room with the evil one, who can only manipulate the darkness. The truth is, he is just as afraid of the dark as you are. That is why he tries to steal your light. Once held, it burns his sight. This once beautiful being cannot be redeemed. Yet flesh was pressed upon the Holy Spirit's friend, brother. Birthed by a virgin mother, humbled by age, and pressed on an expiration date. Accused of being the devil, shrunk down to a human's level, but his soul was never cold. He was beaten and killed, yet rose, so hell is not where we go. All of these power, and we still rebuke the one who rebukes our storms. Thrills and pills, and all of every sin spins around your death, breathing decaying corpse. You are not the walking dead, just flesh hosting a dead spirit. Your remedies are worse than gravity. You pour pure sugar on your cavity. You expect forgiveness to come so quickly. You abuse your right of passage to his throne, thinking you somehow own that road when that road was bought, because your sin was too high of a cost for you to pay your debt. Are you not concerned with the living being within your chest? Are you satisfied with your sack of lies? Purity is not the amount of good deeds. It is listening to his words and taking the time to heed. It is saying no to greed. It is watering that seed of life and not listening to the corrupt feed that tells you because of your breed you are safe from his wrath. My fear is not being pure enough. There is no being in hell or heaven that can separate his love for me. But sin makes me so ugly. What scares me is that God can love someone I never knew. For he knew me. I just never knew how much. Apologies. But I'd rather not base my relationship on luck. Thank you.